Today's topic is all about our lungs, our beautiful lungs here. So here's where they lie anatomically. They're really high up in the chest and they're on either side of your heart. Your heart's right here and here is your lung. And just like the heart's encased in a lot of connective tissue for protection. And the lungs are too. They've got about three or four layers of connective tissue around them. And between two of those layers, there's actually fluid in between. And again, you've heard me talk about the importance of fluid in the body and balancing that. And because what? We're 60, 70, 80% fluidic. And it's a really important piece of the puzzle to make sure our fluids are moving. And it's no different around the lungs. Another thing that you can think of when you think of the lungs is the connection, the apex, the top of the lungs, I mean, they're right around here. So there's actually tissue that comes from C5, 6, 7 here, your vertebrae here, and actually attaches onto the top of your lungs. Interesting, right? I bring a lot of awareness and treatment to that when I'm doing treatment with my hands because of the power it has of really helping people to have less neck pain. Another thing with osteopathy that we study a lot is embryology. So how we grow, because that tells us the design of where the fascia is connected to when we study how we became human and how we grew. Now the lungs are little buds as we're an embryo in your mom's belly. And then what grows out of that lung bud is the tissue that then becomes our arm. So there's a huge relationship osteopathically between shoulder issues and the lung. And now you know the neck because of the anatomy. And as well, and then you know it's covered in a lot of connective tissue and some of those layers have fluid in between them, so we want to make sure that's moving. And again, it's on either side of your heart. The heart and the lung, we can agree, is the most important organs of the body. When those aren't working, we die very quickly. And so they are fully encased in our and protected by our rib cage. Now, one more thing about the lungs that's of interest to you is that there's different lobes, and in between the lobes is that connective tissue. We call them fissures. There's lung fissures between the lobes. And a lot of times they go in line with a rib, okay? And so if there's a lot of tension in your lungs, maybe you have asthma or the emotion that goes along with lungs, according to Chinese medicine, is grief. So maybe someone, you've had a lot of loss in your life. This could be where you're storing some of that grief. And again, what that means to me is it's just what's decreasing the mobility. Is it emotional? We call everything a lesion. Is it emotional tension or is it physical from posture or a big car accident? These are the things we think about. Now, these fissures, you want to make sure they're mobile because they can be, you know, disguising and causing some rib pain. And you know, people back there can get really, really, really sore, especially if you're one of the lucky people who gets to sit at a desk all day. These are things I want you to start thinking about, as well as our breath. So obviously the lungs are important for our breathing and they're the reason we can breathe. Now I want you to think about again, if you're only breathing into your chest, you're going to be putting a lot more strain and tension on your lungs than necessary, as opposed to breathing all the way down into your belly. That's a big one. And imagine if you're mostly breathing up here, we are kind of breathing too much with our neck. So you're perpetuating whatever tension is already going on here. Chicken or the egg, I'm not sure. But just the food for thought, things to think about, how connected our lungs can be with our neck pain and our issues with chronic shoulder tension and or pain. And as well, I wanna just share that I went right after massage college back when I was probably 26, 27, I signed up for a year-long cadaver course. This may seem a bit strange to some of you, but cadavers, I mean, it's a real privilege to get to look at a body when you treat bodies. It's a real privilege. So I signed up for this course at a chiropractic college, and every Wednesday night for a whole year, these two other girls and I, we got the whole half of a body to actually dissect. And what we learned was, wow. There was about two different cadavers we were all working on, the group. And it was so interesting because you would be dissecting and be like, oh my gosh, they had a knee replacement, because all of a sudden you would see metal. Or with the lungs, what was fascinating, I think it was my cadaver, I can't really remember, but this, we were taking the lungs out because you can take parts of the body out once you dissect them and then put them back in because you want to look at them. But it was so interesting. So one of the cadavers had, it was like, the lungs just came out in all these little pieces because they were so stuck inside the rib cage. And then the other cadaver, we just, you know, gently could lift the lung out as one piece, which was so interesting to me because likely, I'm guessing, now that I'm an osteopathic manual practitioner now, is that that person whose lungs, even as a cadaver, were so challenging to get out of the body due to all the tension, that they probably had, you know, COPD or some sort of diagnoses that where they were really struggling with their lung mobility their whole life and function. Anyways, I just think that stuff is so cool, and hopefully you thought that was neat too, and not disturbing, because it is a privilege to work on cadavers, my goodness. And what else do I want to say about, so it holds grief, and what I want to tell you is Louise Hay, one of my favorites, she was the first book I read, You Can Heal Your Life, that made me realize that my thoughts, my mind and my body were actually connected, the health of both. And I could influence one or the other by the way my posture and how I was thinking. So here for lungs, she said that the lungs are related to the ability to take in life, right? Without them, we don't have life. So that makes a lot of sense. And then to really embrace it and give more healing to your lungs each day, you can think, I take in life in perfect balance. I take in life in perfect balance. Louise Hay's stuff is great if that's something you're curious about. And she has a list of amazing, a whole list of ailments, the thought, the negative thought, subconsciously or consciously we're having, and then the thought to start to shift it. So I love that about the lungs. And again, remember that in the body, there is the possibility of the lungs storing grief. So if that is part of your story and your history, you definitely wanna be aware of that. And if you have chronic issues, again, holding these tensions in the body can be physical, where it's, you know, we have to change our posture, but it can also be emotional. And a lot of the times it's both, right? We know the research shows that even just standing taller, our mood is better. And when we're more rounded, our mood is more depressive. There's research all about that. So again, all this stuff sort of seems a little intertwined, doesn't it? And what else do I want to tell you about the lungs? I think that's it. I just think it's such an amazing thing to think about, of how it can be in relationship to chronic neck pain, chronic shoulder pain, chronic upper back issues, thinking about those lung fissures. It's really endless. And one more thing I want to point out is the encasing of the lungs comes all the way down to about here. I mean, doesn't mean that your lung goes, if you take a deep breath in and the lungs expand, they can expand all the way down that far. It's pretty amazing. The body, the more you learn about the body, it's the most amazing machine that you can think of. And learning about it's kind of fun. So there you have all about your lungs, and I hope you found that helpful. Let me know in the comments where you think now this might be an issue for you or someone you love. Bye-bye, have a great day.